Hello, welcome again. We are solving GATE 2018 Aerospace Engineering paper. We are solving only the questions from Mechanical Engineering. Question number 47 is, the boundary layer thickness at a location of a sensor on flat plate in an incompressible laminar flow for air is required to be restricted to 1 mm for an effective measurement. If the flow velocity is 20 meter per second with 1 bar pressure, 300 Kelvin temperature and 1.789 × 10⁻⁵ kilogram per meter per second viscosity, the maximum distance in mm of the sensor location from the leading edge is dash equivalent to 1 decibel. According to Blasius solution, we have delta by x is equal to 5 by root Ra. And delta is your boundary layer thickness and x is distance from the leading edge. Okay, and the Reynolds number is Rex, that is rho Vx by mu. Okay, so V is your 20 meter per second. And viscosity is 1.789 × 10⁻⁵ kilogram per meter per second. Okay, and using Gans equation we have P is equal to rho RT. So P is your 1 bar, 1.5 meter per meter square, and R is 287 joule per kilogram per meter Kelvin. And temperature is 300 Kelvin. So rho is from this we have rho is 1.6144 kilogram per meter square. And the Reynolds number is rho Vx by mu. And now we have rho this, and this is 1.5 / 2 / 300. V 20 and x is the distance, and mu is 1.789 × 10⁻⁵. So Rex is 1298423x. Okay, so now we have Rex. Now we can find out boundary layer thickness according to Blasius solution. Putting the value of Rex, and delta is given as the boundary layer thickness is given as 1 mm. It is given as 1 mm, so it is 1 by 1000 meter, or 5 can come here. Okay, so from this we can determine x. So x comes out as 51.93 in mm or 0.05193 in meter. Okay. Next, a thin walled tube with external radius 100 mm and wall thickness 2 mm is fixed at one end. It is subjected to a compressive force of 1 newton acting at a point on the circumference parallel to its length. The maximum normal stress in kPa experienced by the structure is dash accurate to 2 decibels. So this is your structure, and this is 1 newton force, and wall thickness is 2 mm. And external radius is 100 mm. Okay. So diameter as radius is 100 mm, so diameter is 200 mm and thickness is 2 mm. Okay, wall thickness is 2 mm. So as thickness is very small as compared to diameter, so we can take area as pi dt. So pi into 200 to 2, this is 400 pi. Okay. So direct compressive stress is 1 by this area, 1 by 400 pi. Okay, so that is 0.00080 newton per mm. So that is 0.8. Okay, now this direct compressive stress is given. Okay, and now we can use, now we have to find out bending stress also to calculate the total stress. because this P1 kilonewton regards direct compression as well as bending compression. Okay, so bending stress is can be calculated by using bending equation M by I sigma by Y. So M is 1 into 100 and this is just 5 by 64. And the I is 5 by 64, 200 volt minus 196. Of course, because internal diameter is 196, the outer is 200. Okay, so from and this taking this as outer radius, there will be maximum stress. So sigma b bending stress can be given, that is 1.64 kPa. And the compressive stress is uniform in this thin wall tube. Okay, so the total stress will be sigma b plus sigma c at the outer radius. Okay, so this is 1.64 plus 0.8, that is 2.44 kPa in the right answer. Next, a 1 meter long massless cantilever beam oscillates at 2 hertz while a 60 kg mass is attached at the tip of it. The flexure rigidity of beam in kilonewton per meter square is dash accurate to 2 decibels. So given that the frequency f is 2 hertz and omega is given as 2 pi f. This is f is 2 hertz, so 2 pi into 2, this is 4 pi. So we know that the angular frequency in terms of radian is g by deflection. Okay, where g by deflection of cantilever, and this is your 4 pi. So it will be 4 pi square will be equal to g by deflection. So deflection will be your 0.06212 meter. Okay, so so this is the deflection of cantilever, and in case of cantilever with point load at end point, okay, the deflection is given as WLQ by CI. So W is given as mass is given as 60 kg, so it is 60 into 9.81, L is 1 meter, and this is 60 into 9.81 into 1 divided by 3 into EI. So EI comes out as 3158.4 newton meter square, or 3.1584 kilonewton meter square. Okay, so answer is 3.1584 kilonewton meter.